Hi, everyone. Thank you for coming out for the 2023 Film Festival. My name is Lance Armstrong, the broadcasting teacher and advisor for the Colonial Corner Club and WJSV Radio here at Morristown High School. It's been a fantastic year for the broadcasting program. Starting off with our first day of school broadcasting on WJSV, right up until tonight, where we recognize the students in the broadcasting program for their work on these independent films that you are about to see. Throughout the year, the students from the broadcasting clubs and classes produced over 75 videos for our YouTube channel, including concerts, sports, the Colonial Corner Show, the weekly news show, and even a live stream from the red carpet at Morristown on stage. Our channel now has over 1,050 subscribers. This is an increase of over 200 since September. Our radio station has broadcast hundreds of hours of programming, including morning shows, lunch broadcasts from the studio in the atrium, live coverage of football, basketball, and baseball. And we also did a full day of broadcasting from the festival on the green and 24 hours straight with the marathon in May, as well as radio broadcasts from Morristown on stage. None of this would be possible without the hard work of the students in the broadcasting program. As I mentioned earlier, we do a live broadcast on the first day of school, and these kids are here at 6:30 in the morning on the first day of school, and they're happy about it, which is kind of crazy. But it's really been great for me to have these kids here and do all these fun programs and things. So this is our last event of the year, and it's nice to be able to take a moment and recognize the work of the students from the broadcasting program in an event like this. I think you will enjoy the films you're about to view, and I want to thank all the students who entered for their hard work and willingness to share their creativity. I would like to thank our judges, Mr. Faritzada, Mr. Rooney, and Mr. Manolio for their assistance and for their feedback. I would also like to thank Mr. Manning and Mr. Polino for their support of the broadcasting program. We will hopefully get both of them on camera a bit more next year. Thanks to the members of the Broadcasting 3 filmmaking class and the broadcasting students and parents for helping us put this event together. Before we start showing the films, I want to take a moment and recognize the seniors from the broadcasting program who have contributed so much to the program over the past few years. Some of them are fairly new to broadcasting, and some of them were part of the program before I arrived. I'd like to present them with communications cords as recognition for their efforts. I'm going to say a little bit about each one of my seniors, and then I'll ask them to come up for their cord. Carl Fisher was an exemplary student in Broadcasting 1 and 2, and he's responsible for filming almost every band, chorus, and orchestra concert over the past 2 years. Carl is a quiet person, but his dedication to live event production and his willingness to bail me out at the last minute when I really need somebody to record a concert speaks volumes for what he's meant to this program. Carl will be attending Quinnipiac for film and television next year. Carl, come up and get your cord. Emma Ramirez. She's not here tonight, but she took all three levels of broadcasting and was a teaching assistant for one of my Broadcast 1 classes. She also designed the Film Festival poster and program cover this year and last year. Emma was a co-executive producer for Colonial Corner this year and had a hand in editing episodes of Colonial Corner and trying to get host segments from Ronan each month. She spent many hours in the broadcast room and was always willing to help out other students on their projects in front of and behind the camera. She also managed to make her contribution to the broadcast program while being part of MHS Theater, PGC, and working after school. She's not here tonight because she is performing in her last church choir concert. Hopefully, she'll get some rest this summer. I presented her with her cords at the filming of our last news show yesterday. Corbin Sage. Corbin has made the most of their time in broadcasting, working on projects with other classmates. This year, she was part of a creative team with Roman and Elon, making some very interesting content for broadcasting too. Corbin was part of my crew for onstage auditions and media day, and Corbin always has a smile no matter what kind of chaos is happening in the broadcasting area. Corbin is not here. I'll give her her cords the next time I see her. Jasmine Reyes. Jasmine has taken all three levels of broadcasting and was a teaching assistant for one of the broadcasting classes. She was one of our first news anchors, and although she was always reluctant to be on camera, she always did a great job once she was mic'd up and in the chair. She also filled all the production positions in the news studio at one time or another. Over the past year, Jasmine has been working on a documentary project for CoHome, a local nonprofit organization. She recently completed the film, and they are very happy with the results, and it will be shown at a CoHome event commemorating the Americans with Disabilities Act. And unfortunately, Jasmine is not here either. Ronan Flynn. Ronan took Broadcasting 1 and 2, and I noticed his talent early on when, even with remote learning, he turned in quality projects for each module. He has developed into an independent filmmaker, creating two documentaries following the MHS theater program and showing all that goes on behind the scenes and in the hearts and minds of the dedicated theater kids. Ronan also was a teaching assistant for me this year and was able to share his insights with some of the underclassmen. I hope that some of what he showed them will encourage them to follow his path. Ronan will be attending Marist College next year. Ronan, come up and get your cord. So I just saw Jasmine come in. So you missed all the nice things I said about you, but come on up and get your cord. Parker Bay. Parker actually took Broadcasting 2 and 3 at the same time this year. So needless to say, he spent a lot of time in broadcasting. He was always ready to help out with whatever job I had for him throughout the year, from sports hype videos to news segments. He was always up for the task and willing to learn. Despite Parker's focus on sports, both as a radio broadcaster and as our sports anchor for the news show, he has also developed as a filmmaker. He has a good eye behind the camera, and he has grown as an editor. I look forward to seeing him on sports broadcasts in the future, but maybe he'll take a turn and produce a 30-30 documentary for ESPN. Parker will be attending the University of Arizona next year. Parker, come on up and get your cord.
Arizona State, we'll make it clear.
Isis Bookhart. Isis took on the role of co-station manager for WJSV this year. She was one of the most reliable DJs we've had. She's allowed the club to make huge strides with her organizational skills and attention to detail. She has a tremendous ability to speak on whatever her chosen show topic is with a clear point of view and her own specific style. While we still have music shows on WJSV, many of the new DJs who apprentice with Isis have chosen to do talk shows because of her influence. My one regret is that Isis will not be pursuing broadcasting as a career, since she will be studying criminology and pre-law at Howard University. I'm sure that the skills she has developed during her time on the radio will serve her well in the courtroom if she decides to go that route, or who knows, maybe a career in politics. If she ran for any office, I would be happy to vote for Isis. Isis, please come up and get your cord. Corbin, come on up. All right. John Nolan III. John has been part of broadcasting program for many different... has been part of the broadcasting program for a while and through many different circumstances, including a flood that shut down the studio, remote learning, and a change in broadcasting teachers. I'm not sure which of the three has had the most effect on him. John was a teaching assistant with Ronan in my 2A broadcasting class, and he was a calming influence on a class that I could say was a bit boisterous. One of the things that John has said to me this year was that if students got a compliment out of me on a project, it must be something special because he felt that I am very sparing with my praise. Looking back, I feel that maybe I was a bit harder on John only because of the talent that I saw in him. I wanted to push him to get the most out of that talent. The other reason I was hard on him is because he's a Philadelphia sports fan and I am not. His natural calm and composure on a microphone in a live situation is amazing. He even handled a room full of teachers during Spirit Week, just John and the entire teaching staff, as he emceed an hour-long trivia contest. His ad-libs were perfect, and many teachers commented on how well he did. I look forward to hearing him on the radio at Seton Hall and seeing him do live sports coverage someday. Maybe one day he'll team up with Parker again for the Super Bowl. John, come on up. Thanks again to all of the seniors. Good luck next year, and I will certainly miss all of you. Now, we're gonna take a look at some films. That's why we're here. Now we'll be taking a look at five films that were entered, and then we will announce the winners for best editing, best acting, best use of theme, which was flashback, audience choice, and best overall film. For the audience choice award, you will be asked to scan the QR codes around the room on the flyers to select your choice of films after they've been screened. One last thing, thank you to all the parents and guardians who have supported these students and the broadcasting program. And now, I'm going to turn it over to John Nolan for the rest of the program.
Real quick, before we get started, just one. I think Mr. Armstrong deserves a big round of applause. Like Armstrong said, his contributions, his contributions have been probably the biggest part of my broadcasting career, and I've seen a lot in the last 4 years, so he definitely deserves a little credit. I just wanted to start by saying thank you to everybody. This is already a successful event. Already, I think more people are here than last year, which is a really positive thing to note. And I just wanted to once again congratulate all my fellow seniors. And I also want to say I'm co-hosting with Ronan tonight, and he's going to introduce the first film. So Ronan, come on up.
So our first film for the night is called Boxed Up, directed by Starla Marcella. Starla doesn't take broadcasting or is even in the club, so we're all very curious on what this film might be, and we're very, very excited. When going through the attic, character Julie finds a box of items from her childhood, including this rag doll that triggers memories of their time together. So let's give it up for Starla and let's see what she's got.
Thank you. no queen of Texas left Paris in a cloud of smoke. They say she may be beaten, but I know that she's not broke. She's living in a cool green farmhouse. If you go to Houston, be quiet.
Way to kick things off. Looks like we're gonna have to recruit somebody, right? Our only non-broadcasting submission. Next up is the film The Decision, making his directorial debut, Parker Bay. It's not The Decision? I'm sorry, I'm reading the program. I'm just excited for Parker's directorial debut. I'm sorry, I'm getting ahead of myself. So Dreamception is actually up next. That is a film directed by Joey Paisano, who is, I'm not sure if he's here. Parker's in it, though. Let's see. And Mr. Armstrong is also in it. So a few people here are in it. The description, while rushing to get some of the end-of-the-year assignments completed, the sleep-deprived teenager, Buck, goes into a wild dreamception, getting reminded of previous moments in his life that trick him into doing even more work. At the end of the day, will the work even be necessary, or was it all in his head? Guess we'll just have to watch to find out.
I have so much work to do.
Buck, you need to remember how important these grades are for your future. I'm looking at them and they're terrible. Complete your assignments on time. Are you even listening to me right now?
But Ma,
I don't care.
Mr. Apple, yes? Why do you sound like so much work?
I would suggest that you focus on your work. Otherwise, I'm going to call your parents and tell them you're a bad apple.
Why did you do the essay? You already have 100 points.
Should I still hand it in?
If you hand it in, I deduct you points.
Oh, rats.
Good morning, thank you. Good morning, thank you. Buck, why are you handing this in?
I thought it was mandatory.
Not with your grades. Your grades are excellent.
Oh, but I thought it was...
Must have had a nightmare or something.
I guess so.
All right.
You had a bad day. Take one down, sing a sad song just to turn it around.
Kid's really a star. Our next is our next film comes from our little wonder boy Roman Santanello, very talented filmmaker. Give him a round of applause. Come on. Very talented filmmaker.
I opened it.
Thomas, I swear. You're
Shout out to Thomas.
Shout out Thomas.
Great job, Thomas. Thomas, yeah.
But this kid really has incredible vision, and he is a really great storyteller. And he is going to be telling a very interesting story to us tonight. Watch as Roman reflects on his past and his present. Watch as Roman reflects on his past and his present, pushes past his discomfort to write a letter to his younger self. So let's get going. Roman Santanello, everybody.
Dear Roman, this is a letter from you. Not the you that sings on stage or takes a video on any unlocked phone you find.
This is the second time today. Anyway, how's the kids? How's life? Put your phone away, for God's sake.
But a version of you that's just a little farther along the path of where you're gonna be. This is a letter from the version of you that doesn't feel a chemical dependency to an X-Men hoodie. A version of you that has enough courage to try a haircut that your brother didn't get first. A version of you that doesn't breathe through your mouth all the time in fear of your messed up nose just shooting out a bunch of blood. Which, by the way, try not to hate on it too much right now, because people seem to like it nowadays.
The Italian schnoz in its natural habitat.
See, the thing is, man, I've had a lot of things going through my head lately. Like a billion million things all just happening at once, slowly turning my mind to goop. But even with all these things happening, for some reason, you just keep popping up in my head. For a while, I didn't really understand why. Because the truth is, I've kind of taken a lot of pride in the idea that me and you are sort of separate people now. And then I realized that that's kind of it. Because right now, I'm feeling pretty damn confident. But all I remember you feeling is incomplete. And I know that right now, even though you're surrounded by a ton of amazing and wonderful people that could probably help you do this, you're shutting yourself out from them. Even though you know that you shouldn't. See, the thing is, Roman, I know you. And I know no matter what you're doing, you always got the same thought going through your head. Don't be a burden. Don't be a burden. Don't be a burden. Don't be a burden. It's this heavy and awful feeling that just hangs around you like a massive thundercloud. And I know that you think that these feelings don't have much power over you, but like, come on, man, look at yourself. You wake up every single day making sure to put on that same raggedy pair of sweatpants with that same unwashed sweatshirt and snagging those dirty sneakers every single time you need to run out of the house. And what, you think that's because everything's okay? Think about it for one single second, Roman. You lack the desire to change yourself. Not because you're content with who you are, but because you genuinely believe that you're not valuable enough to go through any sort of change. It is a horrible, awful, disgusting feeling, and yet you hide from it. Every single day you hide under your hair, under your jokes, under everything that you present out to the world, so you never have to think about the lack of passion and desire that you got within.
I don't really know why. It's been like this painfully neutral state. Can't really explain it.
And for the longest time, this lack of desire, it just made me hate you. But Roman, I'm not writing you this letter to make you feel bad about yourself or create the illusion that you need to change who you are. I mean, I was never really a huge fan of that whole Ghost of Christmas Future plot anyway. Roman, I'm writing you this letter to let you know that you're gonna be all right.
Where did you learn what it means to reciprocate? How much can I be expected to tolerate?
Oh my God!
Fortnite.
So I started to think about the plans I made for the day. Unpaid. And you just keep on.
Listen, Roman, I know you're scared. I know you're struggling right now, but as cruel as it may sound, you're meant to struggle right now. Because it's through all this confusion and all this doubt that eventually you'll find the places that give you purpose.
Two, one, okay. Hi there, I'm Nolan Johnson. Are you always sick of this happening to you?
Eventually, you'll find the people that make every single day worth it.
I'm having the time of my life.
And one day, without even realizing it, you'll look in the mirror and you'll find me.
Extra cheese, extra box, extra pepperoni, extra cheese, extra box, extra pepperoni.
And I think I'm pretty damn cool.
We will have another film from Roman later, just want to mention, and we'll have a little bit more information on that once we get to the end. Now, we're moving on to The Decision, Parker Bay's directorial debut. This film, I'll read the description for you, titled The Decision. With her senior year winding down and graduation approaching, Mackenzie still has to decide on where she's going to college. As she takes her final walk through the high school, she flashbacks to memories made throughout her last 4 years with her friends. Where will Mackenzie stand by the end of the year? As a senior, I can honestly say this is what a lot of us have been doing the last few weeks, kind of reminiscing on our 4 years. So, see how this film portrays it.
As I'm getting ready for graduation, I am thankful for the people, places, and things that have led me to this very moment. Graduation for me is to remember these things and people who may not always be with me moving on, but will forever have made a change in me that I'll keep in my heart.
Hey, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm reading a book right now.
Have you heard back from any schools yet?
Yeah, I got into the teaching programs at both UCLA and TCNJ.
Oh, really? Do you know what you're going to do yet?
No, I'm still deciding. On one hand, you're going to UCLA and they have a better teaching program, but TCNJ is so close and I'll be with all my friends and it's less money.
Well, whatever you do, I'm going to support you. I'm gonna go so you can get back to reading now. Bye, Mackenzie.
Okay, bye, Aiden. I'll see you tomorrow. I can't believe this is my last time pulling into the senior lot. Although I'm sad about it, I'm happy that I get to relive my high school days one last time. My first day of freshman year with Lila was one to remember.
Oh my god, we're finally in high school. Are you nervous?
Yeah, a little. For so long it's been just us, and now we need to branch out.
Yeah, what homeroom are you in?
I'm in 305. What about you?
I'm in 318.
One main part of my high school career was Aiden. He was my favorite person.
Hey, Kenzie.
What's up, Aiden? Do you know my friend Lila?
Yeah, I think I have gym with her next.
She's really cool. She's like my best friend. I love hanging out with her.
Yeah, we should all hang out together one day.
Yeah, for sure. I'd love to hang out.
Let's get ice cream or something after school this Friday.
As a freshman, I was, like everyone else, initiated into the high school with the good and bad, including seniors pelting grapes at me.
Get out of here, stinky freshman!
Oh no!
John Nolan Music Award for you. This next film comes from me and John Ulrich and William Casseno. It's a personal film, but I tried my best to convey what I wanted to convey through what I was filming, and it's a very personal film for Ulrich as well. And I absolutely have loved collaborating, working on this project with him, and I'm really upset that you've only come to the high school as I'm leaving, because at the rate you're going right now, like, you're gonna be unstoppable your senior year, and I can't wait to see it. In this film, Out of Focus is about finding your passion and something that you love, while remembering your past self and events that took place that led you to finding what you're passionate about. Ronan and John, who are playing the same character, share a passion for the visual art of photography, and is shown through this story. So now I present to you Out of Focus.
Instead of saying all of your goodbyes.
I just want to let everybody know, if you take a look to your right, take a look to your left, you're going to see QR codes. You might remember from last year we did audience choice. So scan those up. Even if you made one of the videos, you can vote. Even if, as long as you're in this room, you can vote. So just take your phone, scan the QR code, and that will be one of the awards chosen tonight. We'll give it like 5 minutes.
You're fresh meat still, man. You're still fresh meat.
Okay. I hope you all enjoyed watching the films today. I think everyone did a great job. Let's give it a round of applause for our filmmakers. Now it's time for our first award, starting off with Best Editing. The top three films scored by our judges were Flashback, Dear Roman, The Decision, and Boxed Up. And if I could get a drum roll going real quick. The winner for Best Editing goes to the Wonder Boy, Roman Santanello, for Flashback. For our award for Best Acting, the films nominated are Out of Focus, John Ulrich, For the Decision, Kira Baskin, For Flashback, Roman Santanello, Dreamception, Jay, and Boxed Up, Alicia. That's right in front of me. And the award for Best Acting goes to... Hold up one more second. Kira Baskin. And the decision.
Kira's not here tonight. Parker, why don't you come up and accept the award from your team?
Yeah, Parker!
You gotta lower it. You gotta lower it.
We can't have Moa's missing head right now. Okay. We gotta get the panda head. It just scare our.
Okay. I'm gonna move this up since my mom told me I was slouching down. So you know what? I'm just taking it out. So our next award is Best Use of Theme. Our three nominations are Boxed Up by Starla Marcello, Out of Focus by Ronan Flynn, and Flashback Dear Roman by Roman Santanello. And The Decision is also on here nominated. The award goes to The Decision. Next up, Audience Choice. These are our three. Our three nominees for Audience Choice are Flashback, Boxed Up, and Out of Focus. That's Best Film. No, it's Audience Choice. And did you? Yeah, you didn't. Nothing was circled, so even I'm still wondering what the winner is. Okay. And the winner of Audience Choice, Flashback Dear Roman. Audience Choice usually gets a loud cheer. I wonder why. Yeah, sure. Together, me and Roman Ronan are gonna do Best Film. Roman, get up there. All right.
That's really been an issue this year. Roman.
What happened like just last week?
You wrote me a pass for Ronan Flynn to my band class.
But did anyone ask any questions, or were they like close enough on the name?
Gallagher accepted. He was fine.
So yeah. So see. So no issue. All right. So for. Top three. Okay. Top three films. You want to read them, Ronan?
Yeah,
Ronan. R-O-N-I-N.
Our top three films are The Decision, Flashback, and Boxed Up.
The winner. How many broadcasting kids does it take to open an envelope? That's the wrong one. What'd you do with the other one? It might take three of us. No, that's read best acting. No. This is not a bit. He literally had the envelope and tried to hand it. Oh, here it is. Okay, best film. Open. I'm holding the microphone. Embarrassing me up here for all these people. This is the right one, I promise. And the winner.
Flashback, Dear Roman.
Yeah, Roman, come on up again. Right. Well, it's a few things time. You want to do the pictures first, and then we'll show. Okay. So we're going to take a few pictures. We have.
Before we're done, I want to. Roman also will be recognized on Sunday by the New Jersey Young Filmmakers for his film Camera Thief, which is going to be receiving the Stellar Award for Comedy. So rather than let them premiere it, I thought we'd premiere it here at our film festival. But now we're going to take a look at Camera Thief. And before we play it, Roman likes to put me in his films, and I'm always yelling at him. But I told him the next film he writes, I have to be a nice teacher. So, and I apologize in advance for my acting.
Horrible.
All right, let's play Camera Thief.
Roman! Roman!
5 more minutes.
Roman!
What?
I have told you not to sleep in my class.
Well, you know, I thought you meant like during class time, you know?
Hey, come here, I gotta show you something.
Hold on, let me just get my robe real quick. All right. What's up?
Now, Roman, what I'm about to show you is one of the most disturbing things I've seen in this department in years. Do you think you can handle it?
Yeah, can I get one large pepperoni pizza, please? Yeah, so that's extra pepperoni, extra cheese, extra box, if you can.
Roman!
I am here, I'm ready, of course I am ready. Let's see this thing. Delivered to the high school.
Whoa.
You know, this is actually the same exact room I saw in broadcasting today, so.
Not quite, Roman. Take a look at that.
It's a pretty solid space.
It's not the space. It's what's lacking from the space. A camera has been stolen from me.
That sounds tough. That sounds really tough. That sounds really, really tough, you know? I can't really help you with that, though. So, you know, I'm gonna go back to my nap real quick. I'll see you later, Osho.
Not so fast, Roman. You owe me for not telling people about that thing with the moose. Roman, what did you do?
I didn't see it coming, okay? It was an accident.
You gotta be,
Just get the shovel. I paid good money to buy her silence on that, Armstrong.
Money that will be well spent on Pop-Tarts as long as you find my camera.
Fine. You got any leads?
Not really, but I wish you luck in your ventures. Armstrong, away!
Okay. If I was gonna steal a camera, where would I go? Okay. Eric?
Yeah, how you been, man? How you been? It's me, Eric. Yeah, how's it been? I'm just leaning against this wall here, and a very nice wall, solid foundation of the school, and it's really good for the shoulders and the hips to, you know, be leaning, you know, good bones in general. Have you been drinking a lot of milk lately, you know?
For a young boy such as yourself, you should really use more milk in your diet. Just use the milk.
Thank you.
Yeah, apparently someone stole a camera from the broadcast department. Armstrong's really messed up about it. You wouldn't have to know anything about that, would you?
Nah, bro. Never even seen a camera. Well, except for the one that Emma uses for a nature documentary.
In here, we have 2 Italian stallions in their natural habitat. Such majestic creatures.
Could you get out of here? Anyway, yeah. If you see someone with a camera that they probably shouldn't have, please, please, please just tell me. It would be a massive help.
No problem, bro.
Great. We have to get that camera back.
I'm sorry, detective, but that's just not gonna happen.
Well, then I guess I'm just gonna have to take it from you.
I guess so. Hey, a duck!
What?
Uh-huh. Sucker!
I'll never catch up to him now.
Hey, got an extra pepperoni, extra cheese, extra broccoli.
That's me. Thank you so much.
That'd be about 11.
Actually, could you hold the pizza for a second?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks so much. Yeah!
Well, Armstrong, looks like I got your camera.
Though the Italian stallions are majestic creatures, they can never tell when they're being documented or when they're being hunted.
Extra pepperoni! Extra cheese! Extra box! Extra pepperoni! Extra cheese! Extra box!
We gone!
Alright, so, go ahead, Mr. Armstrong. I'm gonna start this off with a funny story. First of all, one more round of applause for Mr. Armstrong. Because without him, none of this would be possible. So I want to start this off with kind of a funny story. So earlier this year, me, Mr. Armstrong, Parker, and Thomas did a broadcast at TD Bank Ballpark. And when you do a live broadcast, it may seem simple. You may just think, well, you just show up and turn on the microphone. It's not that easy. It is bags full of things you have to bring. But one thing we did forget, the computer. You think that would be something you would remember, but we had a hero go back and get it. And that man is Mr. Armstrong, pictured here in this car. And we bought him a gas card for next time he needs to drive back and get the computer. Because Thomas, I don't know what else you're gonna forget besides the computer. So here you go, Mr. Armstrong. All right, Parker.
As you may or may not know, Mr. Armstrong is a soccer fan. I know he's a Red Bulls fan, but he also is an Arsenal fan. And he has some mugs on his desk. Some of them may or may have not broken this year. So there may or may not be a replacement mug in here. So here you go.
Over my 2-3 years part of this club and taking the class, me and Mr. Armstrong have had a fair share of differences, but we always. We've always found our way back to just like talking about like I could go on and on for hours talking to Mr. Armstrong about anything. And like I said in our last news broadcast, he has serious wisdom about filmmaking and videography. And you know, back then, like back when I was taking broadcasting too, like when he'd get really mad at me, the only thing that would ever cheer him up were pop tarts.
So I have a bunch of pop tarts.
Wait, what is this one? Strawberry. We got snickerdoodles, strawberry, and s'mores.
Alright, I have one more before the finals. I have one more, and then we have a... Yeah, we have like two more. This one is a little special, because I may or may not have taken a few SD cards over the course of my experience here. And I may or may not have given them back yet, but I will, I promise. So, we have a gift for you that is, I think, hilarious. I want you to open it. It is
a handcuff attached to an SD card. So he can't lose the SD card because it will be attached to him at all times.
All right. This is the last one. I'm not really going to give any hints. I did hear it bark on the way in, though. So, I don't know. There you go. Cake for everybody. And then in a little bit, we'll see about my